guys, and welcome on my channel. I'm Katharina, and today's video is about 5 3D printed items for film photography. Actually, I went into 3D printing about 1.5 years ago, and I did it as a small job, basically maintaining 3D printers. And yeah, a few months ago I got my first own 3D printer, and actually then I started thinking about what's about film photography and combining both things, and yeah, that's the outcome in this video now. The first thing I came up with is actually this piece here. It's a protecting piece for the legs of my tripod when it's folded and I'm carrying it around. So this tripod has really sharp edges, and actually the legs are getting dirty by putting it outside somewhere. So it's a really convenient thing. Before I printed this, I've used a plastic bag, which wasn't really convenient. But with this piece on it, I really could put it into my backpack without worrying about scratching the backpack or carrying too much mud into my backpack. And yeah, actually it also could make the tripod stand into a corner, which was also impossible before. So yeah, probably a kind of inspiration to get one of these pieces for your own tripod. Second thing is this small key here. It's a really small print, doesn't take long to print actually, and it's for spooling up bulk film. Most of the time when I'm using 35mm film, bulk film from, yeah, these big rolls, 3.5 meters, and spooling them up myself by hand in complete darkness in my dark room into the small cartridges. And I used to do these by bare hand. Actually, first I planned to use a small aluminum tube, but it turned out that these film cartridges have a really strange diameter for the hole, so the tubes were either too small or too big. And using just your bare hands is really annoying and not really convenient. So that's why I've ended up printing this small key. It fits perfectly and it's way faster than just by using your hands. Third thing seems to be obvious, but in detail it's not. That's a film box. Of course, there are tons of different files for 3D printable film boxes around and so on, but actually I dug through it and couldn't find what I was searching for, so I've designed my own version of it. And the special about it is actually it's able to carry 120 and 35mm film at the same time. And of course you actually could decide of carrying 6 rolls of 35mm film or 4 rolls of 120 film, or just divide it and go for 2 rolls of 120 and 3 rolls of 35mm film. So to me that's really convenient, and actually it's a small size, easy to carry, easy to pack into your bag, and I really like it. What do you think about the things I show you here? Let me know in the comments, and I really appreciate it if you hit the subscribe button and give me a like, cause this lets this channel grow, and I actually know that you like this content and I will do more about it. We are now at the fourth thing on the list. That's actually one of these viewfinder pieces here. And for the Canon EOS 50E I've got here, it's really hard to get one of these because it's not the actual standard piece which is available for today's Canon cameras, so you have to look on eBay or print your own. I've printed this small piece and it fits perfectly on the camera. I've sticked some of these hobby foam on top with double-sided tape so that it won't scratch my glasses. That's actually the reason why I really need these pieces, because it covers the sharp edges on the camera and protects my glasses from being scratched by it. Last but not least, the fifth item on this list is another spare part. It's actually a lens cap for my Meopta Flexa Red, which was also the inspiration for this channel's logo. So, well fitting, I put it also on the lens cap. And yeah, that's one of the most convenient things, I guess, using it for printing small spare parts, which are hard to get. In this case, it would be about 20 to 25 bucks for getting these on eBay. But actually, I'm a photographer, not a collector, so it doesn't matter if it's the original one. Just needs to fit and protect my camera. I've already an other video on the go about a 3D printed camera, so if you're curious about it, please hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so you don't miss it out when it comes out here on this channel. And see you next video!